9-volt battery. I don't know if you see the little tiny screw there versus the battery. You just see the bearings, the tiny bearings that I have for this crane. I ordered some more now. They are tiny. So tiny. I used to try to do this. Take that and then hold on this one and screw down. No, didn't want to. Right. Why you no want to play the right way? Just do it with some feeling, so two fingers, no force needed, but it takes time. I need this one, I need to loosen that one to get the angled one in. Loosen that a bit. Let's do it this way first now. So if you're a 3D printing guy, woman, or whatever you are, I mean, I can really recommend some fun things like this. There we grabbed it. There, and then we tried to press down this, which didn't want to. That might go. Yeah, look at us. Touch it. And the 3D printer just goes haywire. And tighten that. So united, these parts get bloody strong. I mean, they get very sprung in. I don't know how much it will lift. I will test that when time comes, but I will not try to break it like many channels do. Test the real limit of it, and they break stuff, and oh shit, we broke it. Yeah. Each of these, like now I'm printing out these, and I mean it takes some hours, so I don't really print things for fun in that remark. So I'm not just gonna, oh let's break this and we can always print new. If it would break, sure, I will print new parts. It's printable, and that's so wonderful. It's found on 3D Cult, and he is, where is he? Hold on, I can show you the thingamabob. It's a thingamabob. What's left? Those two, that one. Not too much left. Okay, good. This one? No, I should go in there. Thank you. And I just started with doing my own on Tinkercad. You can go out and make your own 3D files, which I'm doing. And I'm going to make a pontoon crane called Lodbrok. It's a Swedish pontoon crane that can lift 260 tons. It doesn't say much, but it's an old one. Our Lodbrok is so bloody old. Almost need tweezers for this shit. Do I have tweezers? Yes, I do somewhere. There we go. Look at us. Take this. To be pretty careful not to bounce it too much because the screw might jump around. So you see it's very fiddly, but it's fun. I mean the result is amazing. So it's worth every bloody fiddly. I think anyway. What every other person thinks, I don't know. As we got winter still here in Sweden, the cold bloody land. But some Americans think that we have ice bears walking on the street. That's a myth. We don't. I promise. Only these Siberian Huskies, but they are not ice bears. They're dogs. So, 4 screws left and that's just done. I don't know if you want to see it all, 4 screws more, or not. have no clue. That was that screw. Take some more. So I have these that are tiny, as you see my finger kind of 2 millimeters. Then we have this kind also. That's where the Torx head, and it's 2 millimeters, but it's not self-tapping. I bought all kinds of screws I could to help me in this little kind of quest, but it's spring now, so yeah. I mean, it's time for the fun stuff now. Diggers and yeah, whatnot. This doesn't want to accept the darn screw. I can tell you that. Let's just open it up. And this is just to get in the screw in the bloody hole, so I can sink it down, so it can, I can let the screw stand up. Like so. But I told you already, it's busy. If you see the Torx head on this one, that is tiny. Don't ask me what the number of the Torx is, cause I don't know. Have no clue where your screw. Good. The last one. Then we've done this section, and then I'm not going to do any more. There. This one needs to pass some more. Two more screws and we are done with this one. Can do the same again. Let this work. So, I mean, PLA works great in this situation. I'm really thinking it works good. And I don't know when I'm gonna do the next video of this, but I'll try my best. I mean, there has been 2 subscribers I lost, really, yeah, pretty newly. So, but I'm not really. It's taken me two years, I think, just to get 100 subscribers. And the problem is, I'm not gonna do as the rest of the world or the rest of the YouTubes do fancy grimaces and over exaggerate. That's not me, I'm a calm person. And I do everything and nothing. I mean, I do this just for YouTube is just for fun. Yeah, now this one is done. Every screw here is in place. All screws are in place. That is the opposite of these two. So it's stable. I mean, it's then we just add on. We are going to open this though, because we are getting a kind of, we are getting a coupling between next section, and there's going to be a plate here. Oh, there's a screw. We don't want to get hurt on our crane, do we? I guess you see that I use some force and it doesn't really budge. Okay. So for the new crane, this is done. Yippee. By the way, we have the hut here, or the cabin. This is the cabin. It's gonna hang on the swivel plate. So you see, it's got its chair, hand controls, got the monitor, it's called. And I put some LED lights here and pushed them through here into this box where I will have all connections. And it's the electric box in the real life. So if you look up CT360, and you will see this crane, because it's made of a original crane. So everything is equal to the measurements. You can even see the door here. I haven't put the handle on. Hinge. And let's see here. I think, yeah. And I'm going to put mesh in here, as my printer didn't want to do the mesh. I don't know what's wrong, but it doesn't like the mesh. But isn't that okay? This red and white combination. It's not Liebherr, but anyway. Then we got this part that hangs from the swivel. And just get this up there. So it's kind of gonna be something like that, I think. Something like so. Yeah. Okay. Wrong way. Something like so. Yeah, it's gonna be. As it has the stairs up to the swivel plate, where it will hang on the side. And everything is going to be radio controlled, of course. Well, that's me. I love a radio control. This is the house of radio controls. And while we've been talking, which one is the lock for the turning? This one? No. This one? That's the Ender 3, V3, Victor 3 SE, and it's just 100%, but you see, I mean, it's making the whole bloody table shake. It's a great printer, I really like it. It has nothing, no settings for the table. You don't have to fiddle with screws. You just, I mean, I bought it, I got it home, and after 10 minutes, it was running from I took it out the box. So it's a perfect printer, I mean, and it's $250, not like Bamboo Labs, $1,500. But yeah. It's working effortless. Here's a bearing bearing in one of the, this is the thing that will pull around the line. Do-do-do-do. So you got slot here for the line to go through, so it pulls around the carriage. It's gonna be like this one I glued, yeah, sure did. There we go. So this motor is going to sit exactly here. There it's going to sit. And I'm going to get the electric part on it too. So I guess that will have to do for today. It took longer time than I wanted. So, yeah. But you see me make the first part. Then it's just rinse and repeat, rinse and repeat. Oh, yeah. Here's a little cog. That's gonna drive the swivel thingamabob. So I say, thank you. And if you like what you see, please consider subscribing and yeah, whatever. Take care. Bye for now.